or 8. Any 10 o'clock, got a flight out. Yeah, I'm going back out to Japan. I got two Billy truck and a bitch door with a land. Bruce Wayne, I'm Batman. Batman, I'm ooh, best man. Damn. I got my best man. Yeah. I got my. I go to hotels when I step out. Yeah, your boy got a door, man. Come I go man. To nightclubs with a. Yeah, they call me the madman. I ain't no madman. I just go crazy, man. Ball hard, can't face, man. Chopper, rip wasteland. This what happens when you give it a taste life and you give it a wasteland. This what happens when you give it a fake life and then the ape in. I live with birds, man. Sounds like I see it's in there. Hey, I'm on your turf again. This, that, yeah. From the back of it. I got a girl, Brad. Yeah. She go to battle, she. I live with birds, man. Sounds like I see it's in there. Hey, I'm on your turf again. This, that, yeah. From the back of it. I got a girl, Brad. Yeah. She go to battle, she.
Baby, could you? I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sitting right down. I got too much on my mind right now. Try to hear a tale, get my baby 35. That's, I swear, baby, we just kissing. That's it. How could I forget that you done done for me? Baby, gonna take the charge and take the fall for me.
Coach, thanks. CA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Inner Harbor at M&T Bank Stadium here in Baltimore, Maryland. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the New York Jets and the Baltimore Ravens. On the return, it's Tariq Cohen. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Then we're going to 53.
Carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, you can see that they're playing off of each other, got control of the defensive front linebackers. You're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense, because someone's going to get some big yardage.
And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Then we're going to 53.
Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike to 59.
26.
There's the first carry for Tariq Cohen. Room to run inside the 40. That one's good for 35 yards on the ground and a first down.
I know that play went to the left side, and that's what it was designed to do, an outside handoff there. But how about the whole offensive line being involved? Seal the left side where the play was going, what they call play side.
But
how about on the back side? Just taking care of business to make sure no one can get there and disrupt it.
Is the biggest key to left tackle?
Without a doubt. Control that edge. Get out there. You want that left tackle, if you bring your tight end over there. Either way, control the edge of the line of scrimmage. You've got a chance to rumble.
Here we go, 47.
Mike, 46.
They'll try to throw down Prescott. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Patrick Chung. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
And he'll take this one up to about the 13. 8 yards on the ground there, and now they're looking at a third and two.
Let's go.
On third down, Devontae Freeman. And he'll get this one out to about his 14. Just a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. On fourth down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. Back deep, Tariq Cohen. They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. That's pulled in at the 32. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Jets will have a short field to work with as they take over first and 10. And New York set to take the field. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
But how about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said it didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves and maybe reward their defense a little bit. I put some points on the board on this one.
They're throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
Well, they're slinging it, and then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach, and incomplete. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41.
Watch tight end.
Here we go. Wide
80.
Three down.
A second down throw for Prescott. And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. Give him 15 yards on that one, and the Jets move the chains.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar. You
circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
Mike 59.
A first down carry by Elliott. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Here go 46.
Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. That's going to be caught. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. One will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4 yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
To throw is Prescott. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Patrick Chung. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Freeman fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally,
hey, gotta go.
Creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Three down.
And second down, Freeman. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Show him right.
Blue. We got three. Hey, 18.
55 is mine, guys. 55.
Red.
On third down, Trubisky. He sets to fire deep. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Now here's Michael Dixon as he'll kick it away for the second time. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Pulled in at the 24. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the Jets will take over 1st and 10. The Jets offense now works their way back onto the field. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. 2 drives, 2 interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor, maybe break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him, but whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
That goes for a gain of 31.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's 1st and 10 just outside the 30. Looking to throw. Prescott. This will be caught inside the 10. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. He got 29 yards that time. With Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you, it's the Jets in possession.
Here we go.
Now Elliott. That That's going to go as a loss of six, and it'll set him back for second down.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their block, and that one ended up going backwards.
It's second and goal, back to the 8-yard line now. Here's Prescott. Pass incomplete.
So this is what happens when you throw interceptions. That confident veneer that you have gets chipped away a little bit. Maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, under-throwing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions may be in the back of his mind. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight.
59.
Here we go, 46. 46. Now Prescott. Prescott stripped, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. A little careless with the football, and he also had a fumble loss last week, didn't he?
He certainly did, and when I'm watching him play, the one thing that comes to mind is always remember, traffic, turbulence, people around you, two hands. Get two hands on the ball. Grip it tight. I know it looks cool to have it in one hand, but put it away, tuck it away, because you've got to take care of the ball.
Now Trubisky to throw, and the screen unsuccessfully dropped it. He was out there waving his arms saying, throw it here, dropped it, not a good look.
Well, all I can do is just look at him with contempt on that one. As a defensive back, I'm saying, not as an announcer, just like, really?
A little bit of a diva look, isn't it?
Yeah, very much so, because I think what happens is he just had too much time to think. He's wide open now, here comes the ball. And he doesn't concentrate and drops it.
And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So that one will be accepted.
Let's go, run the ball. Blue.
Hey. We got three. Three down.
Red, tough.
Now Trubisky to throw on second. Pressure comes and Trubisky goes down.
Well, if an offense is going to throw the ball in this part of the field, any pass rusher will tell you that's his favorite part. Gets a chance to get after the quarterback. It's almost like a reverse red zone. They can create points using their defense, and this time they take their man down.
On third down, that's Freeman. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. It's a gain of 11, but they're still well short. It's fourth down.
This offense really put themselves in a tough spot on first and second down and needing long yardage to try and pick up a first down. And they end up getting a great run. Explosive, picked up nice yardage. You don't expect to be in this situation on fourth down. But guess what? It all started with what happened on first and second down. Really put them behind the eight ball.
An unbelievable punt there. We're talking 70-plus yards. And the Jets' offense will be backed up to start this drive as they've got it first and 10. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he'll be taken down for a loss back at the 3.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12.
Here we go. Sliding.
A second down throw to Prescott. And now Prescott is going to be taken down. He couldn't get away, and that's a safety. So after a scoreless first quarter, we at least finally get some points on the board.
But it can't be what either of us expected, can it?
No. The safety's not what you expect for the first points of the game, but one of the goose eggs is gone. He's going to field this at the 4. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. The results for them so far, not that great. Well, not good at all. 3 drives, 3 punts.
Yeah, and now what you're doing is you're looking at your play sheet. You're trying to figure out what you're going against defensively. I wonder, are they showing them something they haven't seen or anticipated in practice, and maybe that's throwing them off? Or do they just have to go to a different play calling section and try and run some offense that way?
They'll come up 2nd and 6 now from the 24.
Blue, blue, blue. Blue, blue, blue. Red, red, up. Behind, hide.
On second down, here's Trubisky.
Tighten up.
Over the middle, Smith. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong arm guy with the right foot in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They get 14 on that one. That's good for a Baltimore first down.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last two possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
On the heels of that good carry by Devontae Freeman, here's first and 10.
Three down.
Looking to throw, Trubisky on first down. But it's caught on the right side at Smith. That throw good for 4. It's second down. Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6.
Three down.
And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
Red, up!
We got three, fellas.
On first and 10, it's Trubisky.
Let's go!
And he's going to be grabbed and pulled down.
Good job, fellas. You better talk to your boy, have him protect you.
2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Baltimore after this. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. And now 10 carry for Freeman. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. Now here's a timeout defensively. Defensive timeout called by the Jets. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. On third down, that's Freeman. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. Now the Jets are going to burn another timeout. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now here's Michael Dixon. He's been terrific so far. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. So out now come the Jets. And, of course, coming off the safety the last time they had the football. I never want that.
No, that's pretty unique, too, isn't it? When you give up points that way on the scoreboard, you look up and it says 2-0, it can throw you a little bit. Let's see if they can put that to the side and move forward.
So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
They'll try again from the 20 on second and 10. They play fake down. Now Prescott. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. They'll run it now at the goal. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
59, Mike, 59. Prescott looks to throw on first. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
46.
Prescott on first down. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Now Prescott. And now he'll tuck it in line. Oh, Prescott stripped, and it's picked up by the Ravens. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk-reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football?
So, should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the same play.
Exactly. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half.
Come on, come on.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Up from his linebacker spot, Deion Jones making the play. We now proceed to the start of the second half.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside where they can really shred your defense.
And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the lead now. They'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else. And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Red, up!
On second down, Trubisky. He's got Freeman here. It's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That one good for 13 and a Raven first down. Well, you think he loved the protection he had there all kinds of time.
And you're so right. How could you not love that? Great protection. The big guys up front, locked in on it. No one gets near the quarterback. He's got all the time in the world to survey the field and deliver for a first down.
And the big boys up front, the big reason why they're winning, too. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
From the shotgun is Trubisky. Throw right side, taken in by Pettis. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. That catch good for five. It's third down. The Ravens on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This will be third and six.
Hey, we got three down.
Red, up!
Mike 55.
Now it's Trubisky. And that is incomplete. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Lock in. Hey, 18.
Check. They'll try and throw for it with Trubisky. The attempt on the dive, and he has it. What a catch. Mike Tomlin takes a shot here, but to no avail. And the Jets are going to get the football back. Good starting position for the Jets as they come up first and 10.
26.
Prescott from the gun. Nelson Aguilar. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
41's the will.
Tighten up.
They give to Elliott. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Get out. Here we go, 46. Gun.
Prescott now on second down. And that's incomplete.
That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And almost intercepted. That would have been his third pick in this game alone. Instead, fourth down.
He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off two passes. That would have been the third in the game. And boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
And now they're going to go for it. This isn't fourth and inches. This is fourth and 14.
Let's go.
Here we go, 46.
Mike, 53.
Throwing, Prescott. And that is going to be incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. The Ravens offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally. And you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now.
Three down.
Again, they'll run with Freeman. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Workhorse tonight, Freeman. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a pickup of 11 at a Baltimore first down.
Whether it's what we call an even front or an odd front, and an odd front's real easy to figure out. If that guy is lined up over the nose of the center, typically that's an odd front defense. Odd number of people, meaning 3-4 versus the 4-3, which is an even front. You've got to control those guys in the middle. Whether it's the nose or the two defensive tackles in a four-man front, if those guys can't get moved, you cannot run the ball in the middle of the field. And in that play, they were able to actually take care of business.
Ben Gideon in on the stop.
Hurry, hurry!
20th carry now for Freeman. And he's going to bring this one down to right about the 20-yard line. Pretty good running there, 9 yards. Sets up a 3rd and 1.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
He may try and run for this. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it.
Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked.
Please tell me this doesn't come off as snarky. But that's a relative chip shot. I mean, you've got to be able to execute that one. I don't care what they design on the other side about trying to block the kick. That should be 3 points on the board.
Yeah, and we've talked about it before. If you're out at 55, 60 yards, low trajectory from here, you get that thing up, this should be 3.
Yeah, there's nothing routine in football, but this one really almost should be. Snap, hold, kick, through the post. Didn't happen that way.
A big run that time by Elliott, 59 yards. The tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the 4th overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
Go, 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 get out there, get out there. 26.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. From the 2 now, 2nd and goal.
20.
They'll run for it with Tariq Cohen. And he is in. Touchdown, New York. A great play there. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Jets are able to strike for 6.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
This is taken at the 3. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field.
Lock in, lock in. Red, red, up. Red, red, up. Gotta go, gotta go.
They'll throw on 1st down with Trubisky. Buying time to his left. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive gain.
Hey, gotta go, gotta go.
Job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a third and about three to go.
Let's go.
These guys have punted four times already and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. On third down, it's Freeman. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Just a two-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. Back now in Baltimore. It's the Ravens with possession of the football, but trailing on the big board as we get set for the fourth. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
180.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And that is incomplete. Mike Tomlin takes a shot here, but to no avail. And the Jets are going to get the football here in great field position. So first and 10 now from the 30. Tenth carry now for Elliott. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get about four there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6. Now I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
He's going to get him running right. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bringing up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal.
Twist,
46.
He's coming. Double up.
46. Prescott down. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. A gain of 5, but not enough. Leads to a fourth and goal.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
And Catanzaro's kick is right through. and that'll push the lead up to 8. And from a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
Red Rant up. Here's Trubisky. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. The Ravens on third down. It's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13.
55's Mike.
Red Rant up.
Hey, D-line, let's get it.
Out of the gun, Trubisky. He's got Rodgers. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. They convert on third with a gain of 22. They'll run it now. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through 3 quarters, no reason to lighten up now.
Let's go.
Of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It's a loss of 4. Now 3rd down.
Let's go.
On 3rd down. They've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. This is 3rd and 8.
Four down.
Hey, 18.
Throwing here, Trubisky. And this one complete to Smith. And he'll get it out to midfield. They'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down. And Mike Tomlin going to roll up the sleeves here and say, let's go for it on 4th.
Red Rant up.
Check. 55.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Over the middle. It's caught by Rodgers. And he's got this down to the 35. They've been burned twice already on 4th down, but the 3rd time's the charm as they keep the drive moving. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10.
Got to go.
Short side. And a short gain down to about the 33. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's 2nd down.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
They'll run it now out of the gun. It'll be a minimum pickup, and it will take us to the 2-minute warning. It's a gain of 1 yard, and it takes us to the 2-minute warning. Time for a break. Yeah, we're back to see 18, what happens 18, 18. After this.
Mike 55.
Red Rant up.
On third down, Trubisky. Complete. Trump has it. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the Jets have recovered.
And I'm feeling like a boss right now. I woke up in